Ladies and gentlemen, it is a thrill to be here tonight. We have some phenomenal award recipients for you. We've got some great special guests, some tremendous leaders in this community, and I couldn't be more pleased than to welcome you on behalf of the Alumni Relations Office and the Alumni Association for the flagship institution in higher learning in the state of New Mexico, in the Southwest, and frankly, coast to coast, the University of New Mexico! Now, Karen told me to keep it short. I'm not sure what that meant, but I'll try and do so. I just want to take this opportunity to say we've got some wonderful, wonderful, talented young folks with us tonight, and it's my pleasure to introduce to you a graduate student who studies vocal performance and opera. He's truly amazing. I had the privilege of listening to him warm up in here before anybody came into the room, and he will just make your heart sing. So give a warm UNM welcome to Ty Cox.
Thank you very much. For many of you in here, I'm also an alumni of some sort. I graduated from St. John's University in 2011 in the tundra of Minnesota. And at my university, we stood for two things: having a sense of community and having a sense of peace between our brothers and our sisters. So I encourage you all tonight to take on those same principles of community and peace as alumni of UNM. So I will sing for you then, "Let There Be Peace on Earth with You'll Never Walk Alone." Can I get a B flat? Thank you. Boom. Thank you. Can I get higher? Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be, with God as our Father, brothers all are we. Let me walk with my brother in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Oh, let there be peace on earth, and let it begin when you walk through a storm. Hold your head up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of the lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. Walk on, walk on, with hope in your heart, and you'll never walk alone. You'll never walk alone.
Bravo! I want to also say thank you to our jazz ensemble who's going to entertain us over dinner. We're joined by some wonderful, wonderful young men. We've got Eric Jeklin, Ryan Rael, and Devin Ryan. Let's give them a round of applause. You know, I'll tell you, with Ty up here, and Ty, you'll appreciate this, I grew up in a home where year after year after year, we'd watch the Muscular Dystrophy Telethon, the Muscular Dystrophy Association Telethon, and for those of you who used to watch that, you know that each year it would end in its early years, the first 20, 25 years or so, Jerry Lewis would always try and get through that song. And all I could think about was how touching it was when he sang it, and then how talented Luciano Pavarotti is. And you were a combination of both. You brought down the house. Let's hear another big round of applause for Ty Cox. So at this point, we're going to give you the opportunity that you've been waiting for, and that is to visit with everybody at this event. So please feel free to enjoy your dinner. Take some time to congratulate our guests, and we will come back up as you're served your desserts. And for those of you like Carl who started with dessert, huh? When you're finished with your meal, I'll come back up, okay? You just give me the high sign. All right, Carl Alonji. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. It's going to be a great evening. Enjoy your meal. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been asked to start the program. The provost has given me permission to do so. And the president has instructed me to do so because he turns into a pumpkin at 8:30. Where is the president? Oh, there you are, sir. I'm sorry. I thought you were out in the hall. Janet told me you'd stepped out.
I stepped in.
Welcome back. How about a big round of applause for the leader of our flagship institution, the University of Mexico, Mr. Bob Frank. Mr. President, you can work your way up here. We're going to ask you to say a few remarks. I want to recognize just a couple of special guests that are with us. In addition to yourself, we have our current regent, somebody who I've come to admire a great deal over the years. She's an incredible leader, not just in the med school as a student and as a colleague to her peers, but really to the institution that is University of New Mexico. She has set the standard, not for what it is to serve as a student regent, but as a regent of an institution she cares deeply about. Please help me welcome Regent Heidi Overton. And then the other standard bearer when it comes to regents, I mean, we've got a couple former treasurers here in the room, and at least we got all the good ones in the room. We've got former treasurer James B. Lewis with us in the room. Where's James? There's James. You know, somebody said, Brian, you got to turn up the energy a little bit. You got to just be a little bit like James B. Lewis. You know, he is Mr. Energy, and I just strive to be just like James B. Lewis, and I'm pleased you're serving on our alumni board. It's quite a distinction and an honor to have you serve with us. Thank you, James. But the other former treasurer that we have, he served with distinction on our Board of Regents. He is an incredible pillar in this community with his wonderful bride, Sarah. We're honored to have him right up here, right up front, former regent, Doug Brown. Thank you, Doug. So without further ado, I think everybody in this room that knows me knows what a big fan I am of our president. You know, it's very rare that someone gets to lead an institution in higher education where they were a student. But not just a student for one degree, not just a student for 2 degrees, but all the way to his terminal degree, to his PhD, all right at the University of New Mexico. When you talk about bleeding Lobo red, this man does it each and every day. He's wearing a lot of purple tonight, so I got him a nice red rose to match mine. And you know what he said when he walked in? He said, Brian, that's a lot of ribbons you have on there. Looks like you got best to show at the cattle auction. I said, Mr. President, that's not very nice. He said, well, thankfully, they didn't give me any ribbons to wear. And I said, well, we're certainly honored to have you lead our institution. It's a pleasure to work side by side. And let's stand tall with this leader of the University of New Mexico, our president, Mr. President Bob Frank.
Well, thank you. It's always hard to follow Brian's energy, but I'll do my very best to tune up my energy tonight for you all. And this is a very distinguished room of people, and I'm thrilled to have a chance to say a very few words before we get to this program of recognizing some really remarkable people tonight. So on behalf of the university, it's my pleasure to welcome you here tonight. Tonight we focus on legacy, a gift, an inheritance, something handed down from someone who has gone before. The four individuals we celebrate tonight are part of UNM's legacy, the heritage we share from our campus to our community, our state, our world. The lives, the works, the accomplishments of John Madison, Michelle Coons, Garrett Sheldon, and Steve McLaughlin are shining examples of UNM's legacy, our life cycle. The gift of knowledge, of inspiration, of innovation given from a professor to student who becomes a graduate, who becomes an alum, who becomes a leader, who makes the world around them a better place. They then clear the path for the next student, the next alum, the next leader. As the university begins its 126th year, and we will continue to expand UNM's inherent qualities and potential. Our alumni represent the story through which we tell our Lobo story. Your legacy becomes our future. Your value enhances our pride. Your accomplishment guides our students' destinies. Many of you heard me say before that our graduates leave UNM with a paw print embedded on their hearts. They take it out to the world. Alums like you, who we honor tonight, leave those prints behind you as you build businesses, you create companies, you generate research, you inspire people around you. You make a UNM degree powerful, valuable, notable, exceptional. Thank you for leaving us your Lobo legacy, for cutting a trail print of paw prints that others can follow into the future. So when I conclude by saying go Lobos, it means more steps, more paw prints. Go forth into New Mexico. Make things great. Go Lobos.
We are joined, when the president joins us at an alumni event, you can rest assured that he brings his team with him. And we've got so many distinguished members of his team tonight. We're honored to host you. And I want to just recognize a few of them, starting with our chancellor for the UNM Health Science Center, Paul Roth. Doctor? And I said, what's the order on this? And they showed me this whole flow chart, and they said the president has rearranged this and that. And so, Mr. Provost, Mr. Vice President, all you distinguished guests, if I got this order incorrect, I apologize in advance, all right? Know that you're all beloved. One of the most beloved at the university. He's been there for some time doing a great job and helping lead the institution, taking it to the next level in our academics. I want to say thank you to the Provost for his friendship, his support, and the good work he does. Provost Chaki Abdallah. You know, at the Alumni Association, we pride ourselves in engaging our community, engaging our alumni, engaging our students, and building that deep relationship that puts that paw print on the heart of our students, just like the president talked about. And when you talk about engaging students, you got to talk about this man. He's all over campus. He's always got a smile and a word of encouragement. Both of us used to have a little bit more hair, but he's still just as distinguished. How about that Vice President Cheo Torres? And of course, we do some phenomenal work for the university and making sure that we have the resources necessary to continue being the flagship in the flagship of New Mexico and the country. And that's our foundation. And we're led by the president and CEO of the foundation, Mr. Henry Nemchik. Where's Henry? We've got a tremendous group of deans that are led by the provost and the president of the university. And I want to just call them out and say thank you for joining us tonight. It's an important evening. We have the Dean of Graduate Studies, Julie Coonrod. the Vice Provost of Extended Learning, Monica Orozco. The always affable Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, Mark Pisani. Associate Dean of that incredible institution at the University of New Mexico called the Honors College. How about a big round of applause for Ursula Shepherd? And if anybody has some big shoes to fill, it's this gentleman here, but he's doing it with distinction, he's doing it with style, he's doing it with passion, and he's making us all proud. I want to say thanks to Dean Craig White from Anderson School of Management. And I'm going to ask you to hold your applause, because we got a lot of great past presidents of the University of New Mexico Alumni Association, and I want to ask them all to stand and be recognized. And I'm going to start with, you'll guess that I'm a lawyer here, because I'm going to start with the former Chief Justice of the New Mexico Supreme Court, right? I don't want to get in trouble, but I want to say thank you, the Honorable Justice Joseph Baca. Those were the people that were not listening when I said, please hold your applause, right? Right? Huh? That was a trick question. Of course, our incredible honoree, Michelle Coons. George, the man, Freiberg, please rise as we call your name. Attorney John Salazar. And Marty Wilson. We also want to say thanks to Jackie Berube, the president, the wife of our past president, Mr. Ray Berube. So let's give them all a round of applause. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your leadership. Freddie? You know what? Let's stand up. Thank you. How about a round of applause? Thank you so much. We got to visit. Nobody added you to my book. I apologize. I'd get in big trouble if I didn't introduce the next gentleman. He's somebody who mentors me. He tells me the way it is, and he keeps me running straight. I want to say thank you, Mayor Larry Abraham, the village of Los Ranchos de Albuquerque. Somebody who I've tried to learn from each and every day because he leads with style and grace, and he's a great chair and trustee for the UNM Foundation, Mr. Carl Alangi, stranger to no one. We also have with us tonight the president of the UNM's staff council, Rene Delgado Riley. And we have one of the best attendance records tonight for our UNM Alumni Association Board of Directors. So I just want to ask them to stand. We have 21 of our 24 directors here tonight. That's how special these honorees are. Please rise if you're currently on the board of the UNM Alumni Association. I'd also like to ask all our former members of the board of the UNM Alumni Association, please also stand to be recognized. See, this is that engagement. It's the gift that keeps on giving. It's the paw on the heart of the lobo that keeps those folks volunteering for the University of New Mexico, and we're grateful. I also want to ask the Cherish Foundation trustees to please stand and be recognized. Dorothy, who else is? We got several members of our foundation board. Please rise. Thank you. We'd also like to say thanks to our awards committee. As each of you know, we have incredible award recipients this evening, and it didn't go without a lot of hard work, time, and effort. There were so many nominees, so many great folks, but these folks really rose to the top in a way that was very special. But it didn't come without a lot of work from our Alumni Association Awards Committee that was chaired by Alexis Tappan. Alexis, please rise, along with your committee. Joseph Baca, Victor Chavez, George Freiberg, Michelle Hernandez, Sarah Cochin, Shirley Rich, and Marty Wilson. Clearly, last but not least, we got to say thanks to the Alumni Association staff. Led by Jane on this event, they have put together a phenomenal evening for you. They've done a great job with this dinner. They've worked tirelessly to make sure that we appropriately recognize these people we care so much about. So I want to say thanks to the UNM Alumni Relations Office staff. I want to ask them to stand and be recognized. Thank you so much for your great work. Talk about engagement and endearment. There are very few people in New Mexico that are as endeared as this woman. She has dedicated her entire life to building those paw prints on the hearts of those people that passed through the University of New Mexico. She's got a special place in my heart. Any success I enjoy has her fingerprints on it. And I want to say thank you, Dr. Karen Abram, for the great work you do for the University of New Mexico. Well, now the moment you've all been waiting for, maybe you were just waiting for me to call out your name, and that's what you were waiting for. But now here we come to the part of the program where we celebrate and recognize four amazing individuals who have come through the University of New Mexico and are now bringing the distinction back to our flagship. The first award is the Faculty Teaching Award. This Faculty Teaching Award recognizing outstanding teaching and service to students. Our language indicates that the recipient shall be a faculty member currently employed full-time in any school or college of the University of New Mexico. We have a couple of past recipients with us this evening. I want to say thank you to Anita Obermeyer, who is a past recipient of this award, and Dr. Acuna, who is here with us tonight. So to say thank you and congratulations to those two past recipients. Thank you, Dr. Acuna and Dr. Obermeyer. This year, our Faculty Teaching Award recipient is Dr. Stephen McLaughlin. Dr. Steve McLaughlin oversees the University of New Mexico's Department of Emergency Medicine, which includes the busiest and most sophisticated emergency room in the entire state of New Mexico. He still pulls several shifts a week at the emergency room, triaging and taking care of patients. But as chair of this department, much of his attention is focused on teaching. Teaching the medical students and residents who will become the next generation of ER docs. It is Dr. McLaughlin's gift as a teacher. It is that gift that we celebrate tonight. Dr. McLaughlin helps medical students and residents perfect medical procedures like intubation, injections, and airway management in UNM's simulation center and on the ground in the emergency room. He also teaches concepts we might not immediately think of as being part of medical education. That important part of medical education that includes critical thinking, how to work in teams, and how to give and receive constructive feedback. Dr. Craig Tim, the Senior Associate Dean for Education at the medical school, says Dr. McLaughlin has everything you want in a teacher. He's witty, welcoming, articulate, and there's that word again, engaged. He sets high standards and demands excellence, but with a personality and charm that encourages students to achievement and excellence. Dr. Cameron Crandall, a colleague, says Dr. McLaughlin's strengths as a teacher come in his ability to engage students all the time in varied settings and to help them examine their work in new lights. He finds teachable moments in just about every moment, every time. Dr. McLaughlin's skills have been recognized with teaching awards from the American College of Emergency Physicians, as well as the University of New Mexico, where he has several times been singled out as Teacher of the Year. Outside the medical school, with his tennis shoes on, Dr. McLaughlin is just as accomplished. He can be found training for marathons, competing in Tough Mudders, and if you don't know what a Tough Mudder is, we'll tell you afterwards. That also includes obstacle courses and running the very difficult, very challenging La Luz Trail. And in the race, he finishes that La Luz in under 2 hours. Unbelievable. We're grateful, Dr. McLaughlin, who did his medical residency, guess where? At the University of New Mexico. Chose UNM as his professional home. We're thankful for his contributions to the medical education and happy to present him with this year's Faculty Teaching Award for Outstanding Teaching and Service to the University Committee or University Community. In addition to this incredible Nambe plaque, the Faculty Teaching Award comes with a $1,500 check, which, by the way, that's why it's the smallest award up here. Huh? We had to pay for the other awards. My goodness. Dr. McLaughlin, how about it? Give a big round of applause for our recipient of the Faculty Teaching Award, Dr. Steve McLaughlin.
Thank you, Brian. So I get 3 minutes. I'm going to try to teach you guys something as well as say a few things. So I want to thank the Alumni Association very much for this. I want to thank the Awards Committee, especially. President Frank, thank you very much. I also want to thank Wendy Stiers from the Foundation, who, as I tried to track down who actually nominated me for this, because this was a complete surprise when I got the email from Jane. It turns out Wendy Stiers from the Foundation, who I've known for many years, actually nominated me for this award. So thank you, Wendy. So I want to congratulate the other award winners. I've got to meet a couple of you today, so congratulations to you guys. And thank you to the Alumni Association staff for hosting this amazing event. I have my family here, and I can tell you my children have never been to a dinner with a live band before, so this is a lot of fun for them. Okay, so I have 2 minutes left, and I have 3 topics to cover, which is, for any of you that are educators in the room, that's a lot of learning objectives in 3 minutes. So we're going to get moving here. Okay, so firstly, I believe that the fundamental purpose of a university are actually teaching and learning. There's a lot of other things we do, but that's the fundamental purpose. I'm very honored as a Health Sciences Center faculty member to be honored by the university for my work as an educator. I want to specifically thank Dr. Roth, who is sitting over here, for creating an environment at the Health Sciences Center where you actually can, as an educator, be promoted to the level of professor based on your work as an educator and your scholarship. And I think that's amazing and unique, and I am very grateful for that. Okay, point number 2, if you're keeping track. So teaching and learning are, by their very nature, in my opinion, is social and community collaboration. And so I want to recognize a few of the very important people in my community that are sitting at my table. So first of all, my wife, Wendy, and my 3 children, Aiden, Alex, and Emma, who together we learn a lot about love, life, supercars, fashion, a software program called Prezi, sewing, and something called FPV Flight, which you don't know about it, you should check it out. It's very interesting. So thank you, family. So I also have 2 of my colleagues from emergency medicine. So Dr. Cameron Crandall. Cameron, would you just wave or stand up? So Cameron is a professor of emergency medicine with tenure. And Cameron has been, as I look back on what success I've had in research, it actually turns out that every single successful research project I've ever had has been a collaboration with Dr. Crandall. So thank you for that. And thank you for your friendship and mentorship over the years. I also want to recognize Dr. Darren Brody, who is also professor of emergency medicine, Darren Wade. So teaching is really a collaborative event, and Dr. Brody and I have, when I look back on the best teaching that I've done in my career, it has been projects that I've done with Darren around procedural sedation, around airway management. We've traveled around the world teaching these courses, and it is a great source of satisfaction for me, and so thank you for the collaboration and the friendship. And then lastly, so I'm still on point 2 if you're keeping track. So a quick acknowledgement. So some of you may know, if you've been here a while, Stuart Menon, who was one of the original faculty members that helped develop the primary care curriculum at the HSC. So when I was a new faculty member here, Stuart Menon and Dina Richter were running the Teacher and Education Development Office, which is now OMED under Gary Smith. But when I was a new faculty member in 1999, Stuart and Dina really fueled my passion for being a literate educator. And so neither of them is here tonight, but I wanted to thank them both because they were really part of that foundation that got me interested in being a good educator. So thank you, Dina, and thank you, Stuart. Okay, lastly, so we're getting to the teaching point. Lastly, so I love feedback. So this is where I'm gonna try to empower you guys and give you some enthusiasm to go out and join me in my quest. So I love feedback. Feedback is the single most important educational tool that we have. My undergraduate degree is from California Institute of Technology, and when I was a freshman, we had a talk which was entitled Feedback is Your Friend, which had to do with feedback in an engineering setting. To me, it has come full circle because now, as a professor, I see feedback as one of the most important educational tools that we have. It drives our attainment of mastery in everything we do. It's a critical element of something called deliberate practice. And I would encourage each of you, as you walk out of here, to ask for and be open to feedback into what you do, and to become an outstanding provider of feedback to the people around you, to your colleagues, and to your students. I think it is a really powerful tool, and I challenge you to go ahead and do that in your career. So thank you so much for your support of teaching at UNM and for this great honor. Thank you.
Make sure you get the check.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brian.
Thank you, Steve, and I appreciate the feedback on the feedback. And for those of you that have feedback on my remarks tonight, I'm going to try and take Steve's advice, but I'd like you to give it to my beautiful bride. She's sitting right over there. So don't tell me, tell her if you got any feedback for these remarks tonight. Those of you that didn't know or were wondering where my wife was tonight, she's cut her hair. She looks so beautiful, and most of you didn't even recognize her. She's sitting right here next to the incredible Dr. Torres, my bride, Aleli Colon. The next award we have tonight is the Erna S. Fergusson Award, and it shall be given in recognition of exceptional accomplishments or for the commitment or distinguished service to the University of New Mexico. The recipient need not be an alumnus of the University of New Mexico. We have lots of past recipients with us tonight, the Honorable Joseph Baca, incredible George Freiberg, the amazing Robert Gish, the counselor John Salazar, and the ever-smiling Marty Wilson. How about a round for all those past recipients of this Erna S. Fergusson Award? But this year, the committee really outdid itself again. We have the 2014 Erna Fergusson Award recipient, the amazing Michelle Coons. And I got to tell you, what I love tonight about having your whole family here is that I have now signed up to be the chairman of the Will Coons for Governor campaign. Stand up, Will, and give everybody a wave. This guy's gonna be governor someday. What a personality. I welcomed him earlier, and then tonight I went by to see how his dinner was doing. I said, Mr. Coons, I said, how's your dinner? And he said, well, it's been terrific. He said, but may I have a little more ice for my water? And dutifully, I went and got you some more ice, right, Will? We're brothers, we're bros, and I'm in on your campaign for governor. You just let me know when you're running, okay? I don't even care what party you are. It doesn't matter. I'm all in. If you haven't met him, you got to meet him. One of the most charming young men I've ever met. Now let me tell you about his mama. Michelle Coon's resume of public service is long, quite varied. St. Vincent's Hospital Foundation, the New Mexico Museum Foundation, Acción, the United Way of Santa Fe, and she came down here, the United Way of Central New Mexico, and many others. But Michelle, who one of her longtime friends describes as Lobo Red all the way through, has also donated her time to a slew of UNM causes. She served on the boards for the UNM Hospital, the Anderson Foundation, and at the incredible young age of 34, just 3 years ago, Michelle served as president of our own Alumni Association. And at 34, she served with distinction, and I'm still trying to fill those kinds of shoes. Michelle's also a chair-elect of our UNM Foundation. She continues to find ways, time and time again, to give back. And with Carl at the helm and you by his side, we're sure to enjoy success, and we're grateful you're there. Michelle is also the past recipient of our UNM Alumni Association Zia Award. But to understand the depth of Michelle's community service, let's go back about a decade and a half to the first Lavender Festival. You remember that, Michelle, at Los Poblanos Farms. When Penny Remby launched the first Lavender Festival, she didn't know what to expect, but she knew she needed a money person. She needed a money person on the board. So she enlisted Michelle, her banker. The festival was a huge success. And to that end, the farm was mobbed with huge turnout with people, cars, bicycles, and traffic jams. So at the end of the day, to avoid the final traffic jam, Michelle got on her bicycle. She got on her bicycle, loaded down, she collected the cash in saddlebags and pedaled the money all the way back to the bank. That's the level of, you got it, engagement, dedication, and service that Michelle delivers to everything she does. Now, I suspect that she hasn't peddled too many deposits to the bank of recent, but I know that you're getting a lot of deposits in the bank and you're doing a great job there. So some things haven't changed. A 1983 graduate of UNM's Anderson School, Michelle went to work for what was then United New Mexico Bank. She was only the second female banker there. She was then I'm sorry, she, her colleague and fellow trailblazer, Roxana Myers, was her only female partner. Myers says Michelle was a natural-born leader, as well as personable and incredibly smart. Michelle went on to serve as president of Wells Fargo's Santa Fe Bank. She currently serves as president of First National Bank of Santa Fe and First National Rio Grande. In fact, Michelle is the first woman president of that bank since its inception in 1870, and I don't think they could have made a better choice. What do you think? She's leading a bank with $1.7 billion in assets. She enjoys her life with a husband and her son, our future governor. She enjoys hunting and fishing. And that would be enough for just about anybody. But not Michelle. Michelle has volunteer service ingrained in her each and every day. Luckily, as Penny Rimby says, Michelle's able to take on about 900 projects all at once. The UNM community, along with the rest of the state of New Mexico and the people who've joined you tonight, including some sorority sisters, how about that Alpha Chi? We've all benefited from your leadership, your friendship, your vision, your passion, and most of all, your engagement in each and every one of our lives. Thanks for your tireless work and commitment to service in our community. It's my honor to present you, Michelle Coons, the Erna S. Fergusson Award, recognizing your service to UNM and the state of New Mexico.
Well, thank you so very much. I'm very humbled and honored to accept the Erna S. Fergusson Award this evening. You've already had the opportunity to meet my husband, Bill, and Will, and I really wanted to thank them for the commitment that they've given, that I give lots of time to UNM. But they make up for it with their Lobo passion for the basketball team. Having grown up in Albuquerque and attended Sandia High School and being the oldest of five children, my parents, Cliff and Shirley Polk, who are here tonight from Colorado, gave me the option to attend any college in the state of New Mexico. So, you know, I had the chance, New Mexico State or UNM, you know, or New Mexico State or UNM. So it only took me 5 seconds to come to the conclusion that bigger related to more fun, which resulted in UNM being my top choice. My love affair with UNM began with those first days of sorority rush and 5 days of being courted by 6 sororities and attending their parties. I accepted a bid from Alpha Chi Omega. I went home, the Alpha Chi's right over there. I went home just long enough to pack my clothes and moved immediately on campus and lived at the Alpha Chi house throughout my college days. Growing up, my mother Shirley continually encouraged me to get good grades because she told me that college would be the most enjoyable and carefree part of my life, and of course, she was right. Pledge class president, sorority president, homecoming court, and of course, an SAE little sister. There's an SAE right back, 2 SAEs right back there. What could make the haze of college days any more fun? A number of my sorority sisters and friends are here, and so I want to thank them for being here. Despite all my extracurricular activities, I finished in 4 years, received an outstanding education from the Anderson School of Management, and was fortunate enough to start my banking career in New Mexico within 30 days of graduation. APS and UNM both prepared me for a long and great career in banking for the last 32 years. Through volunteering, I've enjoyed a close relationship with UNM and have watched it evolve over the last 3 decades. During the first 10 years of donating my time to UNM Alumni Association, I continued to make those personal connections with fellow alumni, which were mostly about fun. Karen Abrams, fellow Alpha Chi alums, Karen Abrams and the alums urged me to get involved with the Alumni Association shortly after graduation. I have been blessed to work with Karen, and our relationship goes back over 34 years when I was a student leader. Karen and I both are in a professional women's group, and when we were challenged to describe our job in a sentence, Karen nailed it, as she is the institutional memory of the UNM Alumni Association. Through the longevity of her leadership at the university and her personal warmth, she has continued to draw thousands of alumni back to UNM over the last 35 years. My second decade of being a volunteer centered primarily on the Anderson School of Management and its activities. I served as the Foundation Board Chair, its National Advisory Chair, Hall of Fame. And the Anderson School is so fortunate that we've recognized to have Doug Brown's leadership as its dean for over five years, and now having Dean Craig White at its helm. So thank you to Dr. Brown. During the last 7 years, my volunteer hours have transitioned to UNM Hospital and the UNM Foundation. For the UNM Foundation, I was on the search committee which brought Henry Nemsek to New Mexico. It was such a critical time in the organization because the foundation had become independent just in time for the recession. Challenging times, budget cuts, but with an amazing staff under Henry's leadership, we have raised over $705 million towards our $1 billion goal. The Changing Worlds Campaign 2020, this last year, raised $78.6 million. Our board oversees an endowment of over $405 million, and we are the core of changing the world for our future students. As noted previously, I'm honored to follow Carl Alonji as its chair this July. Thank you, Carl. Now, Chancellor Paul Roth, Mr. Steve McKernan, and Dr. Cheryl Willman, and the late Dr. Napolitano are all legends at UNM Health Sciences. UNM Med School celebrated its 50-year anniversary, and 40% of New Mexico doctors are either graduates or former residents of UNM Medical School. UNM's Cancer Center is one of 68 premier cancer centers across the nation. It treats all of the state's, the children's in the state with cancer. Everyone knows UNM is the state's only trauma one center in the state. Annually, it sees 90,000 emergency visits and 450,000 outpatient visits. It is the state's safety net and provides millions of uncompensated care each year. Public education defines our citizenry. Let me say that again. Public education defines our citizenry. Private education is important and valued, but it does not begin to touch and impact the masses of our society. As the state's largest public research university, UNM is one of the most significant educational and economic engines we have in the state, while simultaneously providing a world-class health and wellness resource. It educates 28,688 students at an annual cost of tuition of only $6,600 a year. It is an incredible value and a bargain. We now have 185,000 alumni, which has almost doubled since I was UNM alumni president. We are fortunate to have President Bob Frank as its president. He is a change agent. He gets things done. He is passionate and impatient when progress is slow. That is exactly the mindset we need when our state is lagging behind the rest of the country in coming out of this recession. I want to thank our Regents, Heidi Overton, for one of the hardest volunteer jobs in the state. In closing, I want to thank UNM for allowing me the opportunity to continue to grow in my leadership skills over the last 30 years. And although my UNM journey started with a 17-year-old's top priority to have fun, as a 54-year-old 30-year volunteer, I am deeply honored and proud to play a small part in this success of UNM, the Anderson Schools, the UNM Foundation, and the Health Science Center, Sciences Center, which I believe is the most significant contributor to the educational, economical, and physical well-being of our state. Thank you again for this award.
You got my skinny side?
No. I got perfect. The whole thing.
Thank you so much. Congratulations, Michelle. An incredibly well-deserved honor. Thank you for those important remarks. Next, we move to the Bernard S. Rodey Award, and this award shall be made to those persons who've devoted an unusual amount of time in a leadership capacity and whose efforts have contributed significantly to the field of education. And tonight, we have with us Jim Holzman, who I got to greet earlier. He is one of our past recipients of the Rodey Award. Thank you, Jim, for joining us tonight. The 2014 Bernard S. Rodey Award recipient is Garrett Sheldon. He said we could be informal, that I could call him Dr. Professor Reverend Pastor Sheldon, right? So I'm going to try and be a little informal tonight. The Wise College is a 1,600 student branch college of the University of Virginia, set in the Appalachian Mountains of Western Virginia. Garrett Sheldon is in the Department of Political Science and is one of the longest serving faculty members there. From that small college, Sheldon has produced big work. A scholar specializing in early American political thought, Sheldon has become an internationally recognized authority on Thomas Jefferson. He is an incredibly popular teacher at Wise, where he holds the only endowed chair. He served as policy advisor to President George W. Bush and has been a visiting scholar at Oxford. And he has a dozen books to his name, some of which are entitled The History of Political Theory, Religion and Politics, Religion and Political Culture in Jefferson, Virginia, and The Political Philosophy of Thomas Jefferson. Professor Sheldon is not just a gifted researcher and writer, he is foremost and utmost a teacher. His work in the classroom with decades of undergraduates has been recognized by his home state of Virginia. Professor Sheldon is the recipient of the Outstanding Faculty in Virginia Award, which is the highest honor conferred on an academic by the Commonwealth of Virginia. Professor Sheldon is also an ordained Christian minister and the author of What Would Jesus Do? Wise's provost said that he can pick and choose among a strong roster of smart and interesting faculty members when he's trying to figure out who to go to lunch with. That said, he tells us that he finds himself calling on Professor Sheldon again and again and again. Why? Because Sheldon is a sharp, engaging, and funny, but mostly, he's a person who believes his life's passion, his life's mission, is to be a true scholar who believes in a marketplace of ideas and contemplating subjects that range both far and wide. You cannot find a better lunch partner. Jeffrey Morrison, who teaches government at Regents University and shares an interest in Jefferson and Madison with Sheldon, he apologizes for using a cliche in describing his friend and colleague. Professor Sheldon, he says, is, quote, a true gentleman and scholar. The Association's Bernard Rodey Award recognizes achievement in the field of education, and I can't think of a better person, and we are thrilled to bestow it upon our friend, Professor Garrett Sheldon, the true gentleman and scholar.
It is especially gratifying to receive this award from the university that made such a difference in my life and career. Here at UNM, I experienced the excitement of intellectual discovery, free, lively discussion and debate in philosophy classes, political science, economics, English, and especially in the honors seminars. I learned for myself Aristotle's diction that we are a rational, social creature. As Thomas Jefferson, the founder of my university in Virginia, said, "Here we are not afraid to follow truth wherever it may lead, nor to tolerate any error so long as reason is left free to combat it." That free intellectual discussion, hearing all sides, all views, even those that are controversial or offending, is the source of knowledge and all progress, economic, political, social, and moral. Such academic freedom has always been suspect, ever since ancient Athens put Socrates to death for asking questions. But here at UNM, we were not afraid to debate any topic, and we gained the confidence of intellectual growth. Between classes, we students would go to the Student Union Building, the sub, and there we would always see friends, and over a cup of coffee, talk and argue and laugh over the great ideas we'd learned in class. I think at least half of my education occurred there, in the sub, in that friendly, informal, free environment. And my hope and prayer and belief is that this academic excellence will always be here at UNM for all the young scholars that come through its gates. Thank you.
I was inspired. You talked about the sub, and I can't help but think about the student leaders who've come in and out of that Student Union Building and led with distinction. And we have two of them with us tonight. We have the current president of the GPSA, Texana Martin. Texana? Naturally, right? Naturally. And we have Jamie Roybal, one of our former ASU and M presidents, also with us, sitting with our region Overton there. Thank you, Jamie. And let's just say thank you again to Garrett Sheldon for doing tremendous work and bringing distinction to the University of New Mexico. This is an incredible award for an incredible man. The James F. Zimmerman Award shall be given to an alum of the University of New Mexico who has made significant contributions which have brought fame and honor to the University of New Mexico and the state of New Mexico. And indeed, we've had some great ones come through and receive this award. But I'm just going to take a minute to recognize someone we lost this year, somebody who never missed the Alumni Association Award dinners, somebody who we can't thank enough for building this community in a very special and substantial way. Talk about an inspiring man. Talk about somebody who will never be forgotten by anyone he ever met, the incredible Bob Stamm. So we've got Bob smiling over us because he knows we've made a good choice this year in John Madison. John is an incredible individual, and the James Zimmerman Award recognizes this UNM graduate who made a significant contribution not just to the University of New Mexico, the state of New Mexico, but truly to the world. He brought fame and honor to the university by doing these amazing things. It's a high hurdle, but let me tell you, one 1978 med school graduate and a U.S. Navy Vice Admiral, John Madison, clears that hurdle with room to spare. He is truly an amazing individual. Talk about public education. I think it's on this platform front and center tonight. We just had Michelle talk about being educated in public schools here in APS. We've got John Madison, another APS graduate from Rio Grande High. After graduating from Rio Grande High, Madison went to Vietnam. In his first tour, he was an Army infantryman. In his second, he was an ordnance disposal specialist. Now, if you don't know what that is, and I didn't, that's the guy that they send in to defuse the live bombs. So talk about service. Talk about distinction. Talking about an amazing American. When John Madison returned, he used his GI Bill at the University of New Mexico to earn a degree in university studies. He then joined his older brother, Alfred, who was also a Vietnam vet, at the UNM Medical School. The decades following med school held a string of accomplishments for Madison, who enlisted in the Navy, became a psychiatrist, and then earned a master's in public health. That wasn't enough. He had to then go on and get his law degree. He commanded naval hospitals from coast to coast, and he served as medical advisor to the Joint Chiefs of Staff for the President of the United States. He was in the Pentagon on September 11th, 2001, and he helped to organize the evacuation route and assisted in patient triage. He retired with the rank of Vice Admiral, and perhaps the trickiest of his tasks was fulfilling Congress's mandate to merge the National Navy Medical Center with the Walter Reed Army Medical Center. He did so effectively and built two new hospitals and created what everyone knows today as Walter Reed. When he was put in charge of the high-profile and controversial project, his brother Al told him, "John, you're being set up to fail." His wife, Betsy, who was a retired Navy captain. What a power couple, huh? I mean, unbelievable. Betsy often greeted him when he walked in the door after a day at the Pentagon with a cheery, "Can you imagine the captain is your wife?" You walk in and she says, "Are you fired yet?" "No, thank you, sweetheart. Nice to see you too." But Madison persevered, and the results? Remarkable. The results are a state-of-the-art medical center with a special and significant mission to care for the large number of wounded warriors who come home from Iraq and Afghanistan and need our care, attention, and support. After leaving the Navy, Vice Admiral Madison walked the 500-mile Camino de Santiago Compostela trek in Spain, and then he went right back into healthcare. A 500-mile pilgrimage, then he came back to healthcare. He is currently doing amazing things, and he is the president of United Healthcare Military and Veterans, which provides healthcare benefits to more than, get this, 2.9 million military service members, retirees, and their families. What a superstar, what an incredible alum. Vice Admiral Madison, please humbly accept this James Zimmerman Award with our heartfelt appreciation and respect for your service to the United States of America.
Thank you, please. Thanks. What an honor. When I first got a call, Karen Abraham called, and I wasn't sure if it was an alumni attempted contributions from me again. And so I really wasn't prepared. And she said, you know, there's this award that we'd like to, you know, to have you come and accept. And one of my first thoughts was, did they really look at my undergraduate record? And the 70s were fairly turbulent times, and so with that, my attendance record was spotty. what an honor, what a privilege to be able to be here. You know, one of the great privileges for me tonight is to be here with my junior high school coach, Jim Holzman. A Rodey Award winner. Coach Holzman was actually one of the first people to ever tell me that I was going to be a triple threat athlete. I was a threat to myself, threat to my teammates, and a threat to his career. But Coach Holzman, I don't know who doesn't know winningest coach in history, you know, anywhere, anytime. I think what a great coach. But I'm going to take a little credit for his success. if Coach Holzman hadn't had to work with me in junior high, he wouldn't have been anywhere near as ready to move on to Albuquerque High and win the championships that he did. So thank you, Coach. My wife told me that, when he called me up actually after he found out I was getting the award, and my wife said I stood up and started saying, yes, coach, no, coach. I think that I did, too. What a great place New Mexico is, what a great place to grow up, what a great place to go to college. You know, I did come back from Vietnam, went to school on the GI Bill, and there's a number of people in America today, they're doing that same thing. I was able to get a degree in university studies. I wasn't focused maybe as much. I wanted to do interdisciplinary things, and the university studies program actually let me do that. And I graduated, and I went on to medical school. I see Dean Roth back there, and Chancellor Roth, sorry. I want to tell you, I've gone on to graduate studies at Berkeley, Georgetown Law, and there is nothing about a UNM education that is not Ivy League or up to any other standard of education that's out there in America today. It is a great public university, and it is of great benefit to all of the residents of this state, but to the nation as well. I chose a career in the military. Spent 38 years on active duty, and it is a privilege to wear the cloth of our nation in service in that way. Our nation has a covenant with those that it sends out, its sons and daughters, to fight our wars. And the last part of my career, I was fortunate enough to be able to make sure that we kept our covenant with those wounded warriors. 2006, there was a series of articles in the Washington Post that raised concerns about the quality of the care that was provided at Walter Reed Army Medical Center at the time. And in order to restore faith in the way that we take care of our wounded warriors coming back, we put together the National Naval Medical Center, and what at the time was the Walter Reed Army Medical Center, into what is now the world's largest military medical center. It's called the Walter Reed National Military Medical Center. And it provides the greatest in care for our wounded warriors coming back. And it was a privilege for me to be able to do that. In terms of, you know, thanking people, one of the things about service is that you go someplace and you serve. You're not here in New Mexico. And my family is here today, my cousins, my wife. When I left, they were here. When my mother passed away a few years ago, she was 89, lived here her whole life while I was not here. They made sure that she was taken care of. And so I want to thank all of you for all that you did to make sure that I could go out and have the privilege of serving our country. And families, you know, I signed up, they didn't, they got to serve anyway. And so thank you, Betsy, my wife, love of my life, proud to have served with you. You know, it was a real privilege for me to serve our country, and it was an honor to represent University of New Mexico and New Mexico itself. Thank you.
Another round for Vice Admiral Madison. A true hero. You know, this is the engagement that we talk about, and we're so pleased. You know, the Alumni Association calls, and in many, many ways, we're really happy when we can call, and we're not asking for a contribution, although Henry heard what you said, so he'll be calling. But we're so, so pleased to be able to call and say that we want to recognize and honor our graduates, because you continue to be the most valuable currency the university has. You are the most valuable currency because you are our ambassadors. You are the ones that continue to carry the message about the quality of education that is received when you attend the University of New Mexico. So we are grateful to our alums, and tonight we're especially grateful for these award recipients. Thank you so much. And I will tell you, it's an honor to serve as president of the Alumni Association, work closely with the foundation, and there's so much overlap, so many great people, we can't find our way away. Whether you're Lori Moyer, Michelle Coons, or Marty, Judy Zanotti, we travel back and forth between the foundation board and the alumni board. It's because the love is true and the love is deep, and we're grateful for each and every one of you. I want to say thank you for joining us tonight for this amazing event. Again, President Frank, thanks for your continued leadership. Our wonderful Regent Heidi Overton, I'm telling you, I'm hoping that somebody's asleep at the switch for a really long time and you just get to continue serving and serving and serving. And we don't mind that, just not even a little bit. We love having you there. Keep up the great work, and we appreciate it very much. We want to ask the award recipients tonight to come up here for some photographs. You're welcome to please bring your family, our future governor. I'd like a picture with you, Will, if you don't mind. But before we do that, we're going to close with the singing of our alma mater. And so Ty, where's Ty? The amazing Ty. Hey, Ty. Oh, you knew I was going to call on you, huh? You're amazing. You're unbelievable. So Ty's going to come up, and he's going to lead us in the singing of our alma mater. And I know everybody knows it by heart, but if you need to help your neighbor, just show them it's on the back of the program, okay? So I want to say thanks for coming. Have a good time singing this alma mater. And don't forget, go Lobos!
Future Governor Will Coons, I'll get your autograph. So let us all stand and sing the alma mater. Let's all sing it in tune, shall we go? After four, after three, one, two, three. New Mexico. Let's start again. That's another song, right? One, two, three. New Mexico. That's still wrong. Dore. That's right. New Mexico, New Mexico, we sing to honor thee. This golden haze of college days will live in memory. This praise we sing will ever ever ring with truth and loyalty. New Mexico, your fame we know will last eternally. Yes, bravi.
Bravo.
Thank you.
Thank you.